You see, the statement of the problem has changed. Believe it or not, you are already immortal. You do not need our present at all. The treasure is within you. All Agni Yoga can do is to help you to discover it, to raise it, and to use it. Agni Yoga is something like instructions for use, for the application and the development of our higher potential. Of such instructions, we are in urgent need. Scarcely any one of you has the slightest idea of the gigantic potential that lies dormant within him. Scarcely any one of you really makes use of his infinite possibilities. For the time being, you are like the rich man who suffers from hunger because he does not know that there is a treasure in his cellar. He is not really rich as long as he does not discover his potential and does not make use of it. Let us finally come to the third and last step of our experiment Immortality. Transform the world. The scourges of our time, which render life on this beautiful planet almost unbearable, are selfishness, greediness, the chase for money, power, and pleasure, the battle of everyone against everyone. If you look at it more deeply, you will find the cause of nearly all evils is the egotism of man. In order to transform the world, we have to conquer the all-present selfishness. Only immortal beings can succeed in this, because only they can act in a truly unselfish way. We ourselves have to change if the world is to become a better place. As long as you remain the old mortal man, you are continuously concerned with the survival, the welfare, and the spoiling of your body. You think that you have to fight against your brothers and sisters in order to grasp a share as big as possible of the limited goods of this world. You believe that the complete extinction of your existence through death is closely before you. You therefore feel entitled to think only of yourself. You fancy that you have to enjoy to the full the time, much too short, which remains for you to live. As soon as you have become an immortal being, you will think completely differently. As a spiritual creature, you are not in need of material things, which you will have to leave behind upon death anyway, neither for your survival nor for your well-being. Material pleasures do not satisfy your soul. You will no longer be concerned with the fate of your perishable personality, whether it lives in poverty or prosperity, in health or illness. Whether the short time of its existence on Earth lasts some years more or less. All this is entirely insignificant in view of the eternal life of your true self, your soul. For an immortal, the so-called struggle for existence is a concept deprived of any sense. In a situation where there is really not enough for everyone, he will gladly renounce his share in favor of the others. A soul grows when it gives, not when it takes. A soul longs for giving itself completely away in the service to the common good. A soul longs for sacrificing itself for ideas like truth, justice, beauty, and love. The society of the future, communities of immortals, will be organized in a way quite different from ours. We replace egotism by unselfishness. We replace the chase for profit, power, and pleasure by the service to the common good. We replace competition and mutual cheating by cooperation. We replace consumption and greediness by frugality and needlessness. And we replace unscrupulousness, lack of dignity, and lack of honor by applied ethics. For practical purposes, that means, for example, in the new world, which is being built by new men, there will be no poverty. All we have to do is to share fairly what we have produced collectively. Then there will be enough wealth for everyone. The unworthy struggles for participation will come to an end. Spiritual creatures compete in managing to live with as few material things as possible. The real cause for poverty is the egotism of men who are unwilling to share. We see the spiritual principle of justice alone can solve our material, earthly, everyday problems. In the society of the future, there will be no unemployment. Here too, sharing is the magic formula. All we have to do is to share fairly the work which is necessary in a community. Then there will be more than enough to do for everyone. The real cause for unemployment is the egotism of men who are unwilling to share. Unemployment is a grotesque notion. Everyone sees that around us there is an infinite need of work. The general imperfection, misery, and suffering can be overcome by work only. In reality, there is much more need for urgent work than we have workers, time, and capacity at hand. We see again the realization of an ideal like justice is the answer to the pressing questions of our time. We shall look at the details of the new communities which are being built by immortals in later broadcastings. At the end of the first broadcasting, we sum up as follows. Agni Yoga offers a complete program for the renewal of the individual as well as of human society as a whole. A new life in the spirit of immortality is the way out of the misery of our time, the basis on which we can completely transform ourselves and human society. The eternal existence of man is the starting point from where we can outgrow our whole outdated thinking and the old world, and from where we can abolish ignorance, imperfection, misery, and suffering. In conclusion, I would like to offer to you the following mantra to accompany you on your way. I know myself. I transform myself. I transform the world.